greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain understanding. This is part 2, answering a challenge by a Muslim named Ari. Your God was born after Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. How can they know about Jesus? Don't be stupid. In the previous video, brother, I gave evidence from 4 prophets, an angel, and a priest. Combined, they clearly reveal and confirm that God was coming in the flesh. Clearly, this disagrees with what Islam has taught you, brother. And it is up to you to choose whether you respect the prophets or one man alone. Let's take a few minutes and examine your assertion again. Your God was born after Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We've talked about God coming in the flesh, right? But we have not talked about what a fleshly human being actually is. I'll give the clear, concise description first and then support it scripturally, brother. A human being is a spirit who lives in a body. The soul connects your spirit to your body. Proverbs 20:27, the spirit of man is the lamp of the Lord, searching all the innermost parts of his being. Ecclesiastes 3:21, who knows whether the spirit of human beings ascends and whether the spirit of animals descends to the earth? Ecclesiastes 12:7, then man's dust will go back to the earth, returning to what it was, and the spirit will return to the God who gave it. 1 Corinthians 2:11, for who knows a person's thoughts except the spirit of that person which is in him? So also no one comprehends the thoughts of God except the spirit of God. A human being is a spirit who lives in a body. Ecclesiastes 12:7, then man's dust will go back to the earth, returning to what it was. This is referring to his body, made from earth. Hebrews 10:5, consequently, when Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifices and offerings you have not desired, but a body have you prepared for me. This reveals the me that is separate or different from his body. A human being is a spirit who lives in a body. The soul connects your spirit to your body. Hebrews 4:12, for the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Your soul comprises certain things, the joints, that which joins your spirit to your body, and within your mind, the thoughts you have. Your spirit comprises certain things, the marrow, and the intents or intentions. The marrow is where life comes from, where blood is produced. Leviticus 17:11, for the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you on the altar to make atonement for your souls. For it is the blood by reason of the life that makes atonement. Let's look again at that verse about the Messiah coming into the world. Hebrews 10:5, consequently, when Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifices and offerings you have not desired, but a body have you prepared for me. The me spoken refers to Jesus, the spirit that is Jesus. His spirit eternally existed with God as God. When Jesus was born, Jesus was not created. Only his body was created during his birth process. So Jesus being born does not mean Jesus was created. In fact, Jesus confirms that he existed with God before creation. John 17:5, Now, Father, glorify me together with yourself with the glory which I had with you before the world was. So Jesus said he shared God's glory with God before creation. Your God was born after Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. How can they know about Jesus? Yes, the act of Jesus being born and having a body created for him was after the lifetimes of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But because Jesus existed before them, they could learn of Jesus as the Messiah. There is simply no requirement that the name Yeshua or Jesus be known to them. But even not knowing his name, Jesus taught Abraham saw or knew of the day when Jesus would come. John 8:56, your father Abraham was overjoyed to see my day. He saw it and was glad. And the Jews also had a follow-up question, just like I'm sure you do, brother. Then the Jews said to him, you are not yet 50 years old, and you have seen Abraham? The Jewish leaders looked at the age of the body of Jesus. They did not understand Jesus was the Eternal One, the First and the Last, the Alpha and Omega. This would be revealed by the Comforter when he later came. Jesus said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, before Abraham was, I am. Jesus declared he was before Abraham was created. And Jesus applied to himself the name I Am, which can only mean the eternal God. Exodus 3:14, God said to Moses, I am who I am. And he said, thus you shall say to the sons of Israel, I am has sent me to you. So Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob knew to worship I am, brother. And there was a time when they did not know the actual name of I am. Isaiah 42:8, I am Yahweh, that is my name. I will not give my glory to another or my praise to idols. Exodus 6:3, I appeared to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob as God Almighty. But I did not reveal my name Yahweh to them. So Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob knew to worship I am, brother. And it is an irrelevant point whether Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob knew the name Yeshua or not. God makes known what God wants known when God wants it known. How can they know about Jesus? Don't be stupid. I hope you understand, brother, that believing the prophets is not stupid. I hope you also recognize that your question is not new, brother. In fact, Jesus the Messiah already answered it directly and totally for you. I pray your heart would stir and yearn for the truth, brother. The truth just makes so much sense, brother. The Bible, the Word of God, has answers for every jihad of Satan against God, brother. Listen to the question in your heart, brother, the one that wants to agree with the truth. I think you had one more assertion to answer, brother, and I'll get to that next. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.